Good day to you. Welcome back to yet another edition of our positive word. A generous spirit is the topic for this episode. A person who has a generous spirit finds it very easy to give. As a matter of fact, giving comes naturally to them. When they see a need, wherever, with whomever, the first reaction is for them to step in to help. When we talk about giving, it is not just referring to finances. It's not only money that we can give. Giving covers a lot of things. As we see in Galatians chapter 5, from verse 22 to 23, the fruits of the Spirit exists in our lives, and if it's in our lives, we should be able to give these fruits to whoever encounters us. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, gentleness, faithfulness, and self-control, all of these are fruits of the Spirit that we should be able to share with the world wherever we go. Galatians chapter 9 verse 7 says, God delights in the one whose heart is in the gift that they give. A generous spirit doesn't find it hard. Even when they're not asked, the first response, reaction, is to want to help, so long as there is a need. We have a world today that tends to look like there are more selfish people who would rather take instead of helping, giving. Winston Churchill says, we make a living by what we get, but we make a life by what we give. What do you give? How do you give? Do you give? This is not just talking about giving to an organization or a church, because the subject of giving is going all around the world today, and it's not in the right way. There's a lot of controversy concerning that. We're talking about giving to other people, whether they're in your family, your neighborhood, your friends, your people you see, strangers, anyone who needs help, and you have the capacity to support. That's what we're talking about. The peace and joy, the love you share, the kindness, all those are parts of giving. So it's not only the money, the finances that we give. Proverbs chapter 11, verse 24. One person gives freely, yet gains even more. Another person withholds unduly, unnecessarily. They keep hold tenaciously to whatever they have, but comes to poverty. Are you a giver? How generous are you with giving? Verse 25 of the same Proverbs 11 says, a generous person will prosper. Whoever refreshes others will be refreshed. That is the law of giving. You give without expecting anything in return, without thinking about the benefits, the rewards. You just see a need and step in to solve it. That's what we're being called upon to do, because that is the right thing to do. Galatians chapter 6, verse 9 encourages us not to get tired in doing what is good, that we will reap at the right time a harvest of blessings when we do not give up. Dearly beloved friends and family, let us not give up being and doing what is right, the good things, giving generously. That generous spirit in us, let's awaken it today. Let us get to a place where we can discern the need without being told, and we will be willing to provide the supplies needed. That's my prayer for us, to give. There are lots of families. Coronavirus has decimated lives, has brought untold hardship to people around various places. We hear about them, we see about them. Let's look in our surroundings and our immediate neighborhoods. Who needs help? How can we help? Can we allow the generous spirit that God placed in us to manifest in the lives of these people? Let us be the answer to the prayer that someone prayed last night, this morning, 2 hours ago, a few minutes ago, because the supplies that they asked for will show up at their doors, because we answer to the call for the generous spirit that God has given to us. And thank you for joining me today. I just hope and pray that we all would demonstrate and allow the generous spirit that God has placed in us to be seen in our works, in our words, the way we interact and relate with people wherever we go. Have a good day. Until I come your way again, it's goodbye for now.